What's up guys, it's Miro here. So I've been meaning to do a PUBG video for some time, and while I was editing I realized that there's some tips and tricks which most of the people don't know about, so I decided to make a tips and tricks video about it. So first and foremost, PUBG is a game of spotting people, and as soon as you see your enemy before he sees you, there's a high chance you're gonna win that fight. So there are four types of spotting according to me. The first one is the cover spotting, the jump spotting, the team spotting and the zone spotting. As you can see in this clip, my friends are covering in this direction as they have spotted a team in the ruins. Both of them are focusing in that particular area. So what I did was I looked in a different direction to check if any team decided to flank us or not. As you can see, I spotted a team far away, but since they were far away, we didn't engage them. But if I also was focusing in the direction where my teammates were focusing and the other team was close by, things could have been gotten a lot worse. So this is an example of cover spotting. And moving on to jump spotting, here I am running at the side of a ridge, and by jumping at this exact moment, I spotted a guy running below it. So jump spotting is a pretty useful technique, because when you jump you can actually cover a lot of area. You can look above the ridges and spot enemies. Also, if enemy is trying to shoot you, you can take a quick peek, jump, then touch the ground again, and you're pretty much in a safe position to spot the enemies and give information to your team and gather some information if you want. This is the team spotting. Here each member has a role to play. Like in this clip, I am in front and I am taking care of the front side. One of my friend is watching the left side, and one watching the right side, and one watching the behind. And here, one of my friend spotted a team on the left side, and we all shifted our focus on that. Also, a quick tip guys, always get into cover first before shooting your weapons, just in case you get knocked down, so it will be easier to revive you. Here one of my friend gets knocked down, and since he wasn't in the cover, the other guy who was shooting at him, he had a clear shot and he finished him off. Also, whenever you are engaging your enemy, always have some kind of cover which you can use to protect yourself from the enemy bullets. Like I'm staying close to a wooden pole, so there's a high chance he can shoot the wooden pole instead of shooting me, and later on I'm gonna get close to the door, have the cover of the wall, and yeah, he just came straight into me. So it's just simple things which gonna help you. I mean, a lot of you already know it, but just few things which gonna help you get better. And the last one is the zone spotting. Zone spotting is really useful in the last zone place, as in this you use the zone to spot people out for you. Here fights were happening in two directions. So what play was, I let them fight and take them out when they were rushing the zone. So I let the zone spot them for me and I took them out one by one. Here I saw a guy behind the rock, and I knew he was gonna rush the zone because we were not in the zone, and that's when people start to make mistakes, and this is the chance where you have to strike. So he rushed the zone without paying attention to me, and that's when I took him out. And later on, I knew there was a guy in this direction behind the rocks, which I knew from the shooting earlier, and he got taken out as well. Zone spotting is really useful because you can use it as per your advantage in the last circle, and it can help you win games easily. Before coming down to shooting tutorial, a lot of you guys ask about which is the best graphic settings, how do you spot people easily. To be honest, it all comes down to your personal preference, whichever suits you better. And here my graphic settings, the only thing which is different is the aliasing. I think on my settings it's on high because it kinda gives a clear vision, and if PC can't handle it, you can try medium or low is better as well. I used to play on low, but I changed it on high. For some reason I like high better. To be honest, don't think about much, whichever makes you feel comfortable, just go with it. Here I'm gonna show you a difference, and this is the high and this is the low comparison. So whatever makes you feel comfortable, just go with it, don't think about it much. Now moving on to shooting tutorial, Okay, so before I get into shooting tutorial, don't be that guy who thinks I have this weapon and the other guy has this weapon is going to kill me easily. The weapon is only good as the person who is using it. So don't worry about it, whichever weapon you are using. You should be like confident in yourself that you can take the other person out. So yeah, don't think about it, believe in yourself and you're gonna do fine. To get better at aiming, but the advice I'm gonna give you is get comfortable with your mouse sensitivity. You should be able to pinpoint your aim wherever you want it to be, so you can have like a perfectly first chance of shooting the enemy before he gets his chance on you. Also, know your preferred weapon in PUBG, because there are some people who are good with snipers, there's some people who are good with DMRs, there's some people who are good with ARs, and some are good with SMGs. So get in the game, take all the weapons which you can find and have fun so you can get a hang of it. Also, an important thing for aiming in PUBG is the default settings are when you hold the right mouse button, your character aims, and when you click on the right mouse button, your person ADS. So I changed my settings a little bit. So when I hold the right mouse button, my character aim down sights, and when I press control, it aims. So I mean, it's all come down to your personal preference, but I think like when you hold the right mouse button, it gives you like a little bit faster reaction time as compared to the click mouse button. So it's all come down to you. You can change your settings if you think those are good. If you think mine are like you're not suited to you, you can play with normal settings. It's all come down to your personal preference, but I'm just stating my own opinion. So yeah. Also, if you're shooting a guy who's far away with a semi-auto or a auto weapon, make sure you shoot your weapon in such a way that it's not fast. If you're shooting it way too fast, you're gonna lose control of your weapon recoil and you're gonna end up missing all your shots. And if you're shooting your weapon slow as compared to your opponent, there's a high chance he's gonna take you out first. So what you have to do is shoot your weapon in such a way that it's not fast, it's not slow, it's in a state of motion. I'm not saying one is better than the another, but what I'm saying is choose whatever which works for you. There's some people who have really good auto fire control and there are some people who can do great with single type fire shooting. It all comes down to your personal choice, so do whatever makes you feel comfortable. Also, important thing on how much FOV you should have. My FOV is kind of in the middle of it, because the higher FOV you have, it kind of gives you a fisheye view, and lower FOV is also good, but it all comes down to your personal preference. You shouldn't be that person. If you think that this guy is getting a lot of kills, is doing good with higher FOV, I should change my FOV to match his as well. But just play with your FOV and whatever settings makes you feel comfortable, just go with it. Now moving on to your backpack and inventory management, on how much ammo you should carry, how much heals you need to carry, all that stuff. So in backpack and ammo management, always carry the default amount of ammo in your backpack and leave the rest of the space for the heals and boosters, because those are the most essential part of the game. If you are in a firefight and you don't have heals, you're probably gonna get loose. So also, if you kill someone and you're getting flanked by some other team and you want some quick loot from that guy's body, you can always like go to his body and press loot him quickly. As compared to if your backpack is full with ammo, you probably gonna waste some precious time removing the ammo drop by drop, and then you're gonna pick up the heals, but there's a high chance if you during that time the other team gonna shoot you. So don't waste too much time dropping the ammo, looting the body. Always leave some space for the heals and boosters as compared to if you have a lot of ammo. So drop the rest of the ammo. Always carry the default amount. It is more than enough. You're not gonna get into much trouble. If you get into firefight, there's a high chance you're gonna kill that enemy before you run out of ammo and you can get the ammo from his body. Also, important part of looting is always loot from the downside of the inventory, never from the top side, because if you loot from the downside, it kind of much quicker as compared to the top side, because the items remain placed in their location, and if you loot from the top side, the lower item take place of the top item. So if you loot from the downside, it's much faster according to me. I mean, if the top side suits you much better, you go with it, but I'm stating my own opinion. So for me, it's the downside first, than the first than the top side. Now the last but not the least, the crate looting. So crate weapons are really powerful and they can give you an easy win if you have a crate weapon as compared to the normal weapons. So for crate looting, what you should always do is you should first drop the weapon ammo of the weapon you want to drop, so you can have space in your backpack where you can put attachments from the gun you're using, so you can put them later on in the crate weapon, and it saves time and you can get back into the fight real fast. So yeah, that's it for my tips and tricks video for PUBG, and most importantly, I hope you guys learned something new and this video helped you in becoming a better player. I have been meaning to do these kind of videos for quite some time and I'm really glad I did it. If you guys enjoyed the video, let me know down in the comment section. I really don't like asking for likes and comments, but I'm really looking forward for some feedback. Let me know if you guys did like it, if you didn't like it, what I could have done better. And if you did like it, tell me what other things you want me to cover on and I'll start working on those in the near future. Just wanna say again thank you guys for watching the video, and I'm really sorry for taking some time off from live streaming and posting regular content. I got sick, I was having some pain in my chest which was troubling me when I was breathing, but it's a lot better than before, and yeah, I'm coming back and I'll be posting regular content and doing live stream. So till then, have fun, don't worry about it too much, it's just a game, have fun while playing the game and enjoy. And I'll see you guys later. Take care. See ya. Bye-bye.